We are live, everyone. It's morning. Yes, good morning. I almost said good afternoon. Normally, we do this at noon.
That's all right.
But I got things to do, places to go, and people to see today. My daddy used to say that when I was a kid. He said, I got things to do, places to go, and people to see. So thank you for joining us for season 3, episode 2 of Conversations from the Couch. I am your president. I was just about to say I am your fabulous president, which I am a fabulous president, Dr. Daria Willis at Howard Community College. And I am joined by the one and only, whom everybody in the community already knows. I'm really not sure why they invited her on the show, because I don't even think she needs more clout that she already has in the community. But I'm just kidding.
Everybody, listen, the rule is everybody wants to make it to the pink.
To the pink couch.
And in my world, the pank. But the pink couch.
You know, there's a show. What is it? The pink? Isn't it on Stars? What's the name of that show?
I'm not sure. What show? What is it?
Never mind.
Is it Scandalous?
It is Scandalous. No, so we won't talk about that. It's supposed to be PG-13. But maybe join us in the after show with Cody Rigsby and the rest of them. And we'll talk about
sing,
what that show
is. We're going to sing and we might be dancing and all
that. Okay.
Okay.
Join us. We got a board meeting tonight, though, so we can't do all that.
Next time.
Okay, so I am joined here by the amazing, the fabulous, the wonderful Miss Stephanie Wall, who is our chief of staff, and she's over all the special projects at the institution. Stephanie joined us in March of this year, so it's almost a year.
Man, can you believe
it's 8 months already? It feels like she's been here much longer
than
only 8 months. But welcome, man. Stephanie, to the couch.
Thank you. I made it. That's all the sparkling.
And you sparkling with your jacket?
I had to bring a little bling because I was coming to the pink couch.
I didn't know that you were bringing bling. I would have dressed differently, but no one told me what to do. So anyways, Stephanie earned a GED right here at Howard Community College before pursuing her bachelor and master's degree in management with a focus on leadership from Johns Hopkins University. She has worked as a strategic outreach coordinator for the Howard County's office of the county executive, where I kind of stole her from. We'll talk about that later. And I stole her through social media. So we'll discuss that in a little bit. She also has 20 years of law enforcement experience serving as a commander of the community outreach division and the mental health section at the Howard County Police Department. So welcome, Stephanie, to our show.
Thank you. All the juices. We know when you hear somebody give you, your accolades or read your bio, you're like,
It's you.
It's me. I did do all that.
And what we missed and what we didn't say is that you are a lifetime Howard County resident.
I am.
And you have family, ancestors, people. I mean, she can go all the way back to Christopher Columbus?
Oh, not quite back that far. But I will tell you that even here, like we used to be when the Black History Month, they would have an event at the Columbia Mall.
Uh-huh.
And they would bring everything from the college over there, the displays of all of the prominent families, historical families of color, I guess, in here in Howard County, on that board, which is here, I believe in our library here.
Okay.
There's pictures of those families, and both my mother's and my father's family are on those boards.
On those boards. So yeah. She is a living legacy, carrying on all the things and the people who came before her. So we are really honored to have her here at HCC. So as you all know, here on Conversations from the Couch, we dive into honest conversations about topics affecting our community, our students, and our nation. So be sure to drop a question in the comments. We do have some pre-submitted questions that we'll get to first, and then we'll have a Q&A portion later. So let's get started. So Stephanie, let's just talk about a little bit about your journey at Howard Community College. I understand that you were a student parent at one point. So tell us what that is like, because we have student parents on our campus. I was a student parent as well. I had my daughter at 19 years old when I was in school at Florida A&M in Tallahassee, Florida. But a lot of times people say that if you're a student parent during one time period versus the next, then somehow it's just different. I don't know, diapers are diapers.
Yes.
Screaming baby is a screaming baby if it was in 1950 versus today. Now we have different things and ways to support our kids, but can you tell us just a little bit about your journey being a student parent and how and who helped you when you were here at HCC?
So, I always got to tell people, take the journey with me. Now imagine HCC before, Howard Community College before, there were all these amazing, the Set building was here, or, you know, all the other fabulous buildings we had, but this was the only building.
McEwen, this building here, this building was the only one here. Wow.
And this was the nursing building, this entire building. And I...
They were in this office?
I want to say they were down this whole side.
I'm not expecting.
Oh, okay. Never came to the president's office then. I was a very young, I was a teenager. My self-esteem was in the toilet. Nobody, you know, when you're a teen parent, you've now joined a group of people that folks have labeled. So, and your family's kind of ashamed. They didn't have the school anywhere for people that are pregnant. You're pregnant, you just go and be quiet. Well, I had to do something. I had to go to school. I had to finish school. So I came here, and what I later learned, which you guys are gonna learn, is I just learned this thing for years. I was very embarrassed about the fact that I had earned the GED. So in my mind, I was earning the GED. But I just learned from one of our people here in the GED program. They don't call it. They said you didn't earn a GED. You earned a high school diploma. The test is called a GED. Mm-hmm. They would be very proud that I shared that with you all. It was good for me. Because many years, Dr. Willis, I would never tell anyone that I earned my high school diploma through getting a GED, mm-hmm. because I was embarrassed because there's a stigma attached to it. Mm-hmm. So I came here to HCC to take the courses so that I can pass the exam. And I just so you all know, I got to back it up one more time. At that time, you had to go sit down in the room and pass all of those tests, the tests in one sitting. There was no breaking it down. Oh, there was none of those things. You didn't
have a break?
There was
no intermission?
No.
Can't get a water?
Number two pencil.
No water break?
No, ma'am. You leave the room, you the test is over.
No water boy outside?
None of that. Oh. You sit down.
No microwave
some
ramen noodles?
No, ma'am.
Can't bring a PB&J? Okay.
No, come take one part of the test one day and come back. No, everything at one time.
How many tests was it?
It was a lot. Oh. I think it was like 3 or 4 hours.
Oh, wow.
And let me tell you, I can remember like it was yesterday, opening that envelope. And in the envelope was my high school diploma. Swear to you, I dropped to my knees and I cried because, see, society won't let you grow, won't let you be anything. Mm-hmm. And I know that they already labeled me teenage mama. Mm-hmm. So I came here to Howard Community College and I was taking these courses. I didn't know what to do. I was just like, okay. So at some point they were like, okay, we're going to put you in this project called Project, you guys used it for something else, but it was called Project Excel. Mm-hmm. And that was for teenage mothers who wanted to get their GED and go to school.
So can I ask you a question about that? Mm-hmm. Was it that you couldn't continue high school because you were pregnant? Or was it a choice that you made or your family made for you that because you were pregnant, you needed to leave high school to do this other thing?
Well, for me, I was pregnant. I made some bad choices and the school helped me up out of there.
Oh, okay.
Right? And, but it also, you could not go back to public school pregnant.
Oh,
you could not go into the regular classes. You have to come back. There's somebody I can come back next year.
Oh.
Yeah, I could come back.
So you had to sit out.
Yes. And but I didn't want to come back to school with my baby sister.
Mm-hmm. Mm.
Right? Mm-hmm. And up until that moment, nobody had told me how amazing I was. Mm-hmm. No one. Mm-hmm. But here at Howard Community College, while I'm going through this, I have low self-esteem. I'm just showing up. I just keep showing up. And there was downstairs where the Galleria is. It used to be like an office management course. Because, you know, I'm trying to learn how to do typing, all this good stuff. Use the computers. Oh, my God. Word processing. It was the 90s. Doggone it. I'm in there. And I wish I knew. And I probably could look up the teacher's name. But I remember, like, that there were some people trying to get me to come out into the Galleria, kind of hang out. And I every day I would be there. And she said, Stephanie, they're here for recreation. You're here for education. You can do this. Mm. You can do. That was the first time, actually the second time, someone had told me I could do it. I could be more than I believed in my head. Mm-hmm. The first time was Mrs. Talaferro, Mrs. T, my seventh grade teacher. Mm-hmm. Jimmy, you're just way too pretty to be so angry. Because how was she to know mm-hmm. that life was terrible for me at home? Mm-hmm. She didn't know what I was living through. And neither did the woman, the teacher here. But those two people poured into me and made me believe I can do something. So if it wasn't for the me earning my high school diploma through my GED, through an HCC, if it wasn't for me completing those college courses dually, this is for dual enrollment, this is Project EXO, I never got a chance to walk across the stage like all the other students here in Howard County. Man, I cried about that. But you know where I got to walk across the stage? Here and down here, Smith Theater, I have the picture to prove it. I walk across the stage earning my certificate and, from the Project EXO program, and because I earned my GED.
Now, isn't that a story?
Isn't that a story? Mm-hmm. And now, full circle, here I am back here at the very school that allowed me to get all those things. Because if I hadn't completed my school diploma and I hadn't got those college courses, I wouldn't be able to transfer them to Johns Hopkins. So that I can, my undergraduate, which would not allow me to get my master's degree, would not have allowed me to come back here and serve as your chief of staff.
That is wonderful.
For Howard Community College, the very college that means so much to me in the community that I lived in, because I lived right across the street. I walked over here in the snow, in the heat, and sometimes
there'd be nobody. Back then?
Baby, listen here, real snow.
Okay. I saw the snow almanac thingy or whatever it was that was posted this morning.
Yeah, you weren't even born. Let me find out. What the almanac?
Something that was posted today about the prediction for the weather in winter in Maryland. But okay, that's a whole different subject.
No,
I'm getting nervous thinking about the snow.
But no, all sorts. That was in the 80s. It was the 80s. So just imagine that.
Mm-hmm.
But the last snow that I remember that was ridiculous was 1996.
Oh, okay.
But before that, I'm going to say the worst snow maybe was 1986-87.
I wasn't here yet. I was here then.
And I was here, and I was walking through snowdrifts trying to get to the school.
I was a toddler.
Because it was open.
That's awesome.
But guess what?
Huh?
There was me and that instructor. Doggone, I got the A or the B or whatever I got. But hey, but I'm telling you, I share that decision, and I hope somebody's listening. And particularly if you are an instructor or a teacher or a faculty or whatever you are, if you serve these young people in this school, you don't know what they're going through, and you don't know why they're here or what keeps them here. It may be you. It may be you that says you're here for education. They're here for recreation. You can do this.
Mm. So then tell us the story then of how you chose John. Like, how do you go from teen parent earning or taking the test for the GED to earn your high school diploma? You can't go back to your high school, to Johns Hopkins University.
Oh my gosh, can I tell you, I very proudly post my degrees. In fact, I have another copy at home on my wall, because I need to see that, because some days I have to say to myself, how did I end up there?
Mm-hmm.
One, you know, I continued on taking courses. You know how most of us, we're going to be lifetime until we can get there. I'm taking courses, I'm taking classes, and at this point, I'm now working. I'm because of my credits I've earned, I'm able to elevate within the police department. So I'm elevating up in the ranks. So the neighbor's like, well, listen, you know.
So you went to the police department before going to Johns Hopkins?
Yes.
Okay. That's amazing.
Yep, I went there, and then I wanted to elevate up in the ranks. I was like, okay, well, I'm going to finish this degree. And so I'm going to go back to school now and go ahead and get these bills and these loans, because the police department only gave you $1,000. I remember I was awarded $1,000 from one of the car dealerships. I earned, they gave out scholarships for $1,000, and I got that. Ooh, so now I got $2,000.
Mm-hmm.
That helped with the books, maybe a couple books. But it,
she said they helped with the books.
Helped with the books.
Not really tuition, but
yeah,
the books.
But then I went and I just kept showing up. I kept showing up. And as a matter of fact, I was just towards the very end, they were like, Stephanie, it's a problem. You can't graduate.
Oh, no.
Because you need a science.
Did you have to take a science
and
math
class? And I
was
like, oh my gosh, what am
we
I going to do?
We had to dissect something?
Guess what I did?
What?
I took astrology.
Oh.
I went and studied.
I don't even know how to spell that.
Well, guess what I did? I studied. I went down to the science center. I did the whole thing, you know, I did all of that. I got this, and I came
here. You went
to
the planetarium?
I went to the planetarium.
And started looking up
at
the sky?
I did everything I could, and I crammed I came here to ACC.
And took the class?
And I tested out.
Oh, you tested out?
Ma'am, don't sleep on what you can do when you say, I got to do it.
Okay, so let's fast forward a little bit more. Because when I sent the wonderful Stephanie Wall a message via social media, and I said, I'm looking for a chief of staff. Do you know of anyone? And I was really like poking at her. And at the time, she was working for our amazing county executive, Dr. Ball, who, by the way, last night just awarded Howard Community College $10 million for our Workforce Skilled and Trade Center. We deserve a hand clap for that. $10 million. She was working for this wonderful individual. And I said, the first time I met Stephanie, she had on this really cute red suit. It was a pantsuit, kind of checkered thing or something. And then she had on these red Chucks. And I said, oh my God, number one, who's wearing red Chucks? So, I mean, with a red suit. And she came to a meeting and I think the county exec was meeting our Howard Pride students or something along that line. I had never forgotten her face and her energy and her spirit and her smile. And I looked her up and did all the things. And I sent her a message and said, I'm looking for someone to do this at the college. And she kind of played coy for a minute. No, I'm gonna help you find somebody. I'm talking about you. So long story short, she's here with us. But I just think that your life trajectory is a testament. And it's one, and that's why I really wanted you on the show, because I meet a lot of students that you don't know what tomorrow is going to bring. And so, and a lot of times we don't know what's gonna happen because of how we started in life. You know, I would have never been able to tell you that when I was 19 and pregnant that I'd be a president of a college. And on my second presidency at that. I mean, that just wasn't in the playbook for me. So now that you are here, you've had this amazing life story. And by the way, she just celebrated 26 years of marriage to her husband. So like, I'm trying to be like her when I grow up. My wedding anniversary is like, I think next weekend. And okay. I actually remember it. Yes.
You're going to do better.
I put on my calendar this time so I wouldn't forget. But anyways, now that you are here and you have these duties, tell us, you spent 20 years with the police department, then you spent some time with the county executive. Now you're at this institution. What does your job entail? Because I think we had a question on, what does a chief of staff do at an institution?
First of all,
you save me from having to go and talk to everybody all the time. But what does the chief of staff do?
All the things. Now,
all the things that I don't want to do.
Listen, to keep you from, to give you the litany of the list.
You see, it's not that long.
Okay. Said the person who... No, but anyway. But so, you know, as a chief of staff, my job is one to support the president and in her support of the board. So I'm also the liaison with the board along with our general counsel. So, but also, she has several vice presidents, and my job is to support her with that and all those administrative functions. And in addition to, like, all those things that come as a chief of staff, an executive person in the chief of staff position, where you do all the administrative things. But more importantly, my job is to make sure that I help the president and the college to implement the vision of the president, to make sure that she is, when she goes out in, and whether she's out in the outside of the walls or the grounds, if you will, of the college, that she is connected. Everybody, not, they don't have to figure out who is the president and how to get to her. We cut all the red tape. This is just as I did with the county executive. When someone, have you ever tried to reach like a president or CEO of a company and you had a little question that will solve a big problem, but you can't seem to get that answer? Was my job to make sure that that small problem or that big problem finds an answer, and that there's no surprises for our president and everyone in this, all these amazing people that I get the honor to work and serve with here at the college, that everybody, I'm not in comms, I'm not in the, right? But I do feel that I am the part-time member of the group because I share everything they put on social media, because it's not, this great thing that we have here means nothing if only we know about it.
That's true. And she attends everything. I feel like Stephanie is my security blanket. You know how little babies walk around with a little blanket or a little, you know, but you're not that. I don't mean it derogatory, but whenever we go out, we are always connected. We go to events together. When she always carries her card, because I can't ever seem to remember my cards, because usually I'm a mess half of the time.
That's my job, y'all.
And she hands her card out, and I have a habit of saying, absolutely, we can meet. Tell me what time. And she's like, okay, I have to get that on your calendar next. So it's been a real pleasure to have you, you know, on staff. And when I read her story, I try to select people that are on my team that students can see themselves in, because nobody is perfect. And especially with our student parents, because it is not, when you're 19, you aren't excited to be pregnant. Yay, I got pregnant.
No kidding.
Right? Yeah. I mean, no shade to the guys, but you can walk around looking like yourself for 9 months. Women have to go through all of these different changes. I mean, and it's great if you have that level of support system, but sometimes it's a scarlet letter that's attached to it, which is why I asked, you know, mm-hmm. what happened? Why couldn't you go back to your high school?
And even you, I mean, I literally had my some friends and some family members, their parents tell them, you can't hang around
can't
with
hang
her
with her anymore.
Because she's a bad influence.
Yeah.
Not because I'm a bad person, but because
Because you're pregnant. As if, you know, you did it to yourself.
Exactly.
But anyways, that's a whole nother topic for another day. Mm-hmm. But so we'll go ahead and get to some questions. Is that a good time?
Sounds good.
For us to do it?
Absolutely. We got a lot of love in the comments today. We had Julie Jones. Well, first of all, we had a bunch of fire emojis and heart emojis, so thank you for sending those.
Fire! Where there's smoke. And that what Jerry says, where there's smoke,
there's fire.
There's fire in Dragon Country.
Speaking of our VP, Mr. Jarrett Carter Sr., he had a couple comments from him saying, you better testify, Chief. I think that was the same.
Yeah!
I forget when it was.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
They got an inside joke going on. I have no idea what they're talking about.
And then full circle, as Stephanie was telling her wonderful story. And we also had Julie Jones, a member of the college here, say, when Stephanie started, I had to remember not to call her Officer Stephanie. Glad to have her on campus now. So maybe a little story there.
Yes. Wonderful. I've known you. Julie has been an amazing person that she is, that you all know her to be. Mm-hmm. I also know her because she's always supported the police department. Mm. In my role, just right, if you guys, right beside here, there's a building that says Community Outreach Division. Well, Community Outreach. I worked in that building, so I was in charge of 22 men and women who their responsibility is to serve everything from the mental health unit everything.
So you were supporting, I'm going to divert just really quickly, because when we talk about police engagement and interaction in communities, you were part of the division that helped police officers understand who the community was, correct?
Yes.
And it's not what we see on TV and in the news, unfortunately. So that is a huge role, right?
Yeah.
And then you slide into the county exec's role, and you coming over here to the college. So you're just like a community agent, community. That's just your calling. She's got all the woo in the world.
That's my number one, Stephanie.
Go woo them. You do that and tell me how it goes. But
you know, I want to say someone told me that they were at the Roger Carter Center in Ellicott City. And they were like, Stephanie, I saw a banner, and your picture was on there.
Oh.
And you may see them all over the county. You'll see me in full police uniform with my bars, because I was a lieutenant before I retired after 20 years. And lieutenant. And that sometimes that comes out, y'all. I want to support. No, you do not. And the same person that you all see today is the same person I've always been as an adult. Once I found out that I was already amazing. It was okay to be amazing. I could be amazing too, like everybody else. Mm-hmm. And so now like you, I'm on a mission. When I see something and I think they're great, if there's something I want to share, I just share. Mm-hmm. Because I know from where I came. Mm-hmm. And I know that when I walk out through these halls and every student in here, every one of them, you know, you said that you meet students where they dream. Mm-hmm. They're all dreaming. Mm-hmm. They all have a story. They're all in the middle of their story. And that they one day will be the very people in here taking our very places. And they're going to be changing the lives of other people. We on that mission.
Amen, somebody. You know, I went to church with her on Sunday. I'm feeling it all from Celebration. All right, what questions do we have?
We have one from Jared Carter, our VP, saying, please ask how she helps senior leadership team to connect with faculty and students.
Oh, my goodness. You know, y'all know I love that. That's my woo. That's my woo. Okay, so full disclosure, y'all, if you see me and someday you say, oh, my gosh, she is the most I am. I love people. People are my thing. And I believe that just like every student in here has, they have a dream and they have a story. So does every senior leadership, every faculty member, every staff member, every person in this building. And if we don't really know each other, that's why I'm glad you had me on this couch. Because you see me and you may have based your opinion on me based on the chapter that you see. But I've lived many chapters and so have you. Mm. And with that...
Can y'all like put that out? I know. Pull that out. I have lived many chapters and so have you. And dropped the mic. I'm sorry.
That's okay. And I am through that. What I do is in my position, because I'm, as Dr. Willis already said, in addition to all the things we do here in this office, I am also responsible for lots of projects like other people. So we have to collaborate. So through those efforts, through meetings, in person, or Zoom, or however we do it, Teams, or the phone, or just us collaborate, however we collaborate, we don't just make it so, what's the word I'm looking for? Not mechanical, but transactional. We don't make it so transactional, we make it more personable.
Like how we now have, which was announced last night, the Boys and Girls Club.
The Boys and Girls Club. Come on, y'all, can we hear it?
Stephanie
the Boys
has
and Girls?
Worked on with a host of other people across the college. So we will have our very first Boys and Girls Club on this campus next fall. It is the first of its kind at a community college with the Boys and Girls Club. So we are going to be a model for the state. She's also working with some of our grant writers and also people in senior leadership on our new child development space. So we're going to have our Child Care Learning Center reopen, hopefully by next fall. We got a $1 million grant for that. So some of the projects Project Elevate, yes, making sure we're getting kids from pre-adjudication, and that starts November 13th,
yes,
before they get into like big trouble. They're going to come here, loosely sentenced or whatever, to HCC to get their what?
To get their high school diploma. They're going to take their and get their test, and they're going to get practice so that they are prepared to get to nail that test so they too can get their high school diploma.
She has worked on this project of taking the high school GED test to earn their high school diploma. So really, this is full circle for you and the types of special projects. And so the goal is really to break down the barriers, the walls of the institution to get more and more people in the door. And Stephanie has been monumental and instrumental in that effort. Do we have any other questions?
We've got 2 minutes, but we do have some comments that I wanted to get to really quickly. Cat Love 84, can't wait for homecoming. And girl, you look great.
To both of you. And, homecoming!
Sammy, 180.98, awesome about the $10 million from the county. So
I stood up last night and did my holy dance. Mm-hmm. That was exciting.
All right, and then we have time maybe for one quick answer. It just came in from King Colin, the coolest. Hi, Miss Stephanie. What's your favorite thing about the job you do at HCC?
Ooh, the people. The people. I love coming on this campus. Can you look that and y'all Dragonfire? I'm gonna put that big in the Dragonfire. I'm ready to go down there right now. The best food
is oxtails.
Yeah, the oxtail with some cornbread stuff.
Y'all
come on
down.
You can get some scones. But the people, most of you, I'm sure, have been on this campus. But if you haven't, go outside right now. Head toward the cafe. The music, the people. This place is amazing. Talk to any student and ask them about their dreams. They'll tell you. It's the people. It's the energy that they give me that I want to come here. I promise you, this is not something I'm telling you just to be saying. This is the truth. I don't know. It's my quote and my granddaughter. Yes, I have a granddaughter. She says, Gigi does not know how to lie. She just tells truth. Mm-hmm. And this is my truth. I love it here. It's the people.
Well, that's amazing. I think that's the best way to end season 3, episode 2 of Conversations from the Couch. So all of our guests get this one, because I'm trying to be like a real co-host or something, or host, whatever, right? And I saw Jennifer Hudson do this one time on her show. I don't even know if her show's still there. But anyway, she had these wonderful, beautiful mugs. And we have our Conversations from the Couch mug. So here you go. Thank you for joining us.
Thank
you.
You
are official now.
I am bona fide. Oh my God.
She's officially official.
Thank you.
So remember, homecoming activities are going on all throughout this week. I believe there's a dance coming up at the end of the week. Today is like 80s dress or something like that. Oh, the dance is on Saturday. There's an alumna reception tonight. They had the wonderful flag football game yesterday. We also have our very own cheerleaders finally. Yes. We talked about cheerleaders.
Yeah, we're going to work on it. We're going to be up there next time.
They're amazing, and they had the cute pom-poms, and I hear that they got some uniforms coming. So I'm very proud of everything that our SGA has done for homecoming week. Remember, please support our $11 million capital campaign for our new Workforce Skilled and Trade Center. It is so very important. It will bring jobs, and people will be able to support their families in our community. And we're hoping to have this thing open in 2026. So we need $11 million to make that happen, on top of the $10 million that we got last night from the county exec. So as I wrap up with everything today, just want you all to know, thank you for joining us. The next Conversations from the Couch, Season 3, Episode 3, is going to feature Coach Mike Smilkinson on November 29th at 12 o'clock. He is our athletics director. He is no stranger to this campus or the community. She has a nickname for him, but that's a whole nother story.
He was the baddest. He was the baddest point guard ever at Long Beach High School. That's all I'm saying.
She knows everybody. I mean, I don't know. I mean, this was meant to be. But I'm so excited to bring Coach Smilkinson right here to our couch to talk about his vision for athletics, because he has a huge vision, and I'm just so happy and ready to support him. So thank you for joining us. Have a great day, and I hope to see you for all of our homecoming festivities. Bye, everybody.